been using Camtasia for publishing my YouTube videos. It is my go-to software for editing the videos, and before I publish it, I do all my edits using Camtasia. This I've been using since April 2020, and over a period of time, I've made many changes to the way I publish my videos on YouTube. In this video, I'm going to show how to overcome one of the limitations of Camtasia 2021, which is the current version I'm using. It's not the latest, but that's the one I have free access to as part of my Microsoft Most Valuable Professional or MVP benefits. And that has been my editing software for quite a long time. Let's go and see what is the problem I'm facing with this edition or with this version of Camtasia and how I managed to fix it. So here are a couple of videos I published using the Camtasia software. First one is this install Kdaon Kubernetes using Helm chart. This was published about 3 weeks ago, and you can see that this video is published in 4K size or 4K resolution. And if you go into this options here, you can choose one of these resolutions to display the contents of this video on your screen based on the capabilities of your screen. You can go all the way to 2160p at 60K or 60 frames per second. That's the 4K resolution which is supported in this video. And you also have the standard 1080p at 60 frames, or there is 1440p at 60 frames. These two are the HD resolutions or HD formats. This is possible because I record my videos using iPhone and then I import it into Camtasia. Now, when I record it using 1080p resolution in the settings of iPhone at 60 frames, I can easily import that particular video without any problem. Recently, I shifted to using 4K resolution to record my videos on iPhone, because not many people know that iPhone is a very handy camera. We can record videos even in 4K resolution at a very crisp images, or the videos can be very crisp in terms of the way the content is captured when we record it using 4K option. And I recorded this particular video, which was again published recently, just about a couple of days back. This one was recorded at 4K 60 frames per second, and when I imported it into Camtasia 2021, the resolution was all over the place. I had to use another third-party utility for Camtasia called as the Fuse to transfer this video from my iPhone onto Camtasia, and you can see that clearly the resolution of this video is way off the limits compared to the 1080p, which looks much more crispier. So in fact, this should have been much better since this is recorded in 4K, but because of this limitation in Camtasia where it doesn't support natively the 4K resolution at 60 frames per second, it gives this video which is very weird looking, and I don't like this. So to fix this problem, what I did was, so here we are inside the Camtasia. It's a new project, and let me start by importing the image which I want to, or importing the video which I want to use with 4K resolution. So this is that img_0387 movie file .mov format. When I import it in Camtasia 2021, we can see the video here, and when I add it to the timeline, you can see that the video is completely blurred. And if I produce this output, this is exactly how the video would look in the actual output as well. This doesn't look really good when I play it, and I don't want to use this video as the video for my YouTube video. So the way to fix this is, we can use this built-in software called iMovie. And in this, we can go and again click on the import media. And let's go and use that same file here. So if the file is residing under the Docker build folder. It's that same video, 0387.mov. When I use the import option, it will import this particular video in the iMovie. And if we want, we can play and see that it is actually the video that we want to use. We can also trim it and do a little bit of edits here, but I'm not going to do that as part of the iMovie. Any additions that I want to do or any modifications, I prefer to do that using Camtasia itself. So once I import this particular video in iMovie, I can drag it down onto the timeline view here, and I go and create a file under the share. So this is the process which will be used to transform this video from a 4K iPhone.movie file to a MP4 format, which will result in a little bit of reduction in the quality of the video, but it will still be better than what we were seeing earlier. So click on this file option, and we can see that under the default options, if we go with the resolution of 1080p, it would create a file of the size 1.83 gigabytes. This is the estimated size. Now here I'm going to change it to 4K resolution, and under the quality we can choose low, medium and high. High is the currently selected one. If I choose best with pro resolution or custom, or when I choose best, in fact, it will go and create again a .mov file. I don't want that because that is not compatible with Camtasia 2021. So I'm going to choose high here. And when I select the high option, you can see that the estimated file size has gone from the initial 1.8 gigabytes to 4.5 gigabytes. So it does increase the file size. In terms of compression, we can again choose between better compression or better quality and faster one. I want a better quality video here, so I'm going to choose better quality. Then go and click next and select where do we want to store the output of this particular video. Currently I'm storing it under documents, and we can give the name. So I can give a name as Docker builds here, and this will be saved in that particular folder. This takes a bit of time, and we can see a small circle here, and that shows the progress of transforming this video from a 4K video to a MP4 video. Since this takes a bit of time, I've gone ahead and already created this video or already transformed this video earlier. I'm going to use that in Camtasia. So when I go into the Camtasia again and I go in the import media, here I have this Docker build feature.mp4 file, which I converted using exactly the same process which I showed just now. Now, if I add this particular file, the Docker build.mp4, to the timeline, you can clearly see the difference. The video is much more cleaner, much more crispier, almost same as the .mov resolution. So using this approach of converting the file which is in .mov format, the 4K format at 60K recorded in iPhone, we copy that video over to the Mac and then use the iMovie software in Mac to convert that MP4 or that MOV file into MP4 format. And once we import this MP4 file in Camtasia, we can use it as part of our regular edits. I can do all the other operations that I do using Camtasia, and the video quality is much better, much cleaner, much crispier, which we can see in the recent video that I published. So here you can see the latest video, which is currently private but will be published on my channel very soon. The quality of this video in terms of capturing the background and all the images, they are much more crispier compared to the similar video which was captured at 1080p. So I hope you found this video useful, where we converted an unsupported version of 4K resolution video captured on iPhone 4 or captured on iPhone and recorded at 4K with 60 frames per second, which isn't compatible with the Camtasia 2021 edition. And by converting that into a MP4 format using iMovie, we are able to work around with this limitation. Hope you found this video useful. Do let me know in the comments what other things you would like to see on this channel. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell button to get notifications when new videos are published. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.